Hello, this is Leonardo, and in this video I'm going to show you the new member of the Wood family, which is called Flame. It's an analog distortion, and it's based on... I modeled three different guitar pedals. So I've been playing guitar for a long time, and I love guitar pedals. And over the years I have made my own versions of it. Like real hardware versions, but I wanted to have these kind of distortions in VCP rack, so that's what I made this module. And it's basically three different distortion pedals, and I added as well three different tone circuits, which can be found in other pedals, and put it together, and here you have it. So you may ask, what's the difference between Flame and Debreatus? Debreatus, it's also a distortion, but it can be considered more like a wave shaper, because it's a static model. What that means is that there is no frequency pre-processing, or it doesn't affect the frequency content of the input signal, and it just distorted and adds more harmonics. So basically, for every voltage that you input, there is a corresponding output voltage, and that's it. On the other side, we have Flame, which is it's a dynamic distortion. So what that means is that the nonlinear elements, but also the internal components, there are capacitors, there are resistors, there are transistors and operational amplifiers, and these components are not static, so they can form filters, and the output that you get, it will completely depend on what was the input, but not at the immediate time, but also in previous times. So the internals of Flame were based on the distortion pedals, which are made for guitars or to boost the frequencies of guitars. But if you change a little bit the components, you can get something that is usable in a wider frequency range, and which is more appropriate for VCP. So let's take a quick look at it. It's a very simple interface. You have two selectors here, which define which tone circuit and which distortion model you're using. You have a main distortion control, a tone control, and a mix of the input signal and the output. This is the output of Vesek, which is just two triangles playing a sequence. And here we are listening completely to the input. And I'm going to select the first model, which is the rodent model. And I'm going to slightly change the mix of the input and the output. And you can immediately hear the effect. And you can control the distortion level with the fuel control. Here we have maximum. And one interesting thing with this is that the tonal characteristics change, especially when you are in this area with a little bit of distortion. And this specific model, Rodent, has a characteristic that if you set it too low, it needs like a minimum energy to trigger the distortion. And it also needs a little bit of fuel to start triggering completely. So if you blend this with the original signal, you get like these nice like punches. gonna set it like somewhere here. And let's take a look at the first tone circuit, which is the creme. It basically, this tone circuit, what does it, on this side, it's a kind of low pass, but also boosts some of the frequencies. Here we have full harmonics. And what happens here is that it cuts a little bit the highs and boosts the low. Let me show you the other tone circuits. This is called Dies, and this has like a middle point, which is it could be like kind of the plain sound. If you go into this direction, it lowers the low frequencies, and you can hear only the high frequencies. This is also nice to blend with the original, for example, like that. And on the other side, you have only the lows. And then we have the puff, which is similar in behavior. You have the highs here and the lows on the other side. I'm going to use the creme for now. And let's take a look at the second distortion, which is the cylinder. This one, it's a distortion which is like softer than Roland. So I'm gonna start increasing the fuel here. It's not very aggressive and it gives just a little bit of warmth. Let me show you the original signal. That's the original. And that's the process signal. And yeah, the last mode is the blur mode, which is a kind of destructive distortion, but it adds really nice harmonics. So here I'm in the lowest fuel. And as I start increasing it, and depending on the input signal, there are points in which you can get some nice sounds. And of course, combined with the input signal, you can just like warm it a little bit. And that's basically what Flame does. But of course, all the parameters can be modulated to get some nice sounds. For example, let's use Spank and take the gate from here. I'm gonna connect it in the tone circuit. Just to add like a punch in the beginning. You can also connect, for example, here. And then let's use an LFO. Thank you. course, later you can put a filter to change, to shape even more the tonal characteristics of the distortion. So this is it. This is basically Flame, and it's going to be part of the premium package. And yeah, it's, well, there are many points where you can explore, and also, as you may notice, it's a stereo, so it's perfect to process if you just want to add a little bit of warm to some other signal, you can use it, especially if it's stereo, or let's say process some samples and make the samples sound cooler. And yeah, as I mentioned, it's part of the premium package, and it's gonna be available very soon. I hope that it's available in the time when this video is published. And thank you very much. Goodbye.